Hello and welcome to a VEGA talk about our Bluetooth security concept. With me today is Martin, our expert in this field. Martin, can you explain the concept for us?
Sure, Tom. It is important for our customer that the data is transmitted securely. Together with the Fraunhofer Institute, we developed a security concept consisting of three security levels. The standard connection is established between the mobile device and the sensor by the VEGA Tools app with Bluetooth. A distance up to 50 meters is no problem.
When does this make sense?
For a measuring point that is difficult to access, for example, on top of a high silo. At the next security level, access is accomplished via Bluetooth access code. Reading out parameters is only possible if the individual code is known. The Bluetooth access code is checked in the VEGA sensor, but it is never transmitted directly from the adjustment device to the sensor. A so-called challenge response procedure is used here. The Bluetooth access code is saved in the sensor. The user enters this code on the smartphone. For the purpose of checking, a random number is generated and sent to the sensor. Both devices use this number to calculate a new one together with the Bluetooth access code, known to both. It's called hash. The hash cannot be used to calculate the two original numbers.
If one compares the algorithm to addition, for example, 5 plus 5 equals 10, one cannot deduce from the result 10 if the calculation was, for example, 6 plus 4.
Exactly. To ensure even higher security, the sensor then also calculates the random number and sends it to the smartphone. A new hash is then calculated from this and the first hash. The smartphone sends this to the sensor. If both have the same result, a connection is activated for you.
And this prevents others from penetrating the system and changing data?
Exactly. That's why the VEGA parameter protection method was developed. Unauthorized modification of instrument parameters can be prevented with an additional device code. The device code is checked in the VEGA sensor, but it is never directly saved there. Again, a challenge response procedure is used.
That was a lot of information. Many thanks, Martin. If you have further questions, go visit vega.com/bluetooth or contact your VEGA sales representative. Have a look at our VEGA talk playlist if you want to learn more about our sensors. See you next time.